So scientists found out that we need around 20 minutes without any kind of distraction to get into focus. But this is actually the problem of many people in this day and age, because our brain is actually trained to have a small attention span. We are trialed with any kind of advertising and any kind of social media notification, right? So getting distracted today is quite easy. This is why we found ourselves doing anything but actually the one thing that we want to do or we need to do. Hey, my name is Shi, and in this video I want to share with you 5 advice how you can improve your environment around your desk so that you can make sure that you stay focused and retain your concentration. And make sure that you stick to the end, because my last advice is actually the one that will bring the biggest improvement in your life right now. So my first advice for you is to prepare your workspace. So for example, if you are a student right now, or if you are working in your office, then make sure that you have everything you need, books, script, any kind of document already around you. So you don't need to stand up and look for it, right? And also prepare it in the way that you don't need to put a lot of energy to get it actually, right? For example, if you are using a lot of books, try to put them in the vertical alignment, not in the horizontal alignment. Why? For example, you have your book on the stack and you need to pull out the one book in the middle. Then you will need to lift up the other book that is on this one book and then pull it out and then lift it down again. And these are just unnecessary steps that distract you from your current work, right? If you have them in the vertical alignment, you just need to pull them out and then you have it. Then you are done. And this might be a really small change, but try it out, because this makes a huge difference. Because we also tend to really, like I said, to distract ourselves with small things. So make sure that you have everything around you and also easily to access, because this will help you to just retain in your flow and just doing your stuff without any kind of distraction. So, and my second advice is, after you have everything around you prepared, you also want to get rid of everything, really everything that you don't need. And the reason is, everything that is not concerned your productivity will catch your attention and this will distract you. So make sure that they are not in your closed environment. So my advice for you is, clean and declutter your desk regularly. For example, you can do it after you finish with your task or with being productive. And yeah, just clean it, right? Or you can do it somewhere in your day, or at least do it on a weekly basis so that you can make sure that your desk is clean and you don't have any kind of distraction if you want to be productive. So my third advice for you is to have enough to drink around you. You might already know that, and maybe you already read about it, or maybe also made your own experience. But if you are dehydrated, your concentration or the capability of your brain will drop drastically. So this is why it's so important to drink enough during the time when you are productive. So this is why I make sure that I have enough water or tea around me when I know that I need to work on something for 1 hour or even longer. And my next advice for you is to have a decent light source. And the reason is, most of our tasks that we need to do need our eyes. So if we don't optimize our environment for our eyes, we will see that they get really tired soon. So one thing that you can optimize is to light up your desk properly. My mom told me this advice for so many years, but I never listened to her. Now, after I implement this advice, I see the benefit. It really makes it easier to, for example, read something for a very long time. And it's also, yeah, you will see that your eyes aren't tired like it used to be if you were just like reading in an environment with less light. And my last advice for you, and I think you already know it, right? But it's always good to have a reminder, because if you already know it but you never did it or you forgot to do it, this will help you to get back on track, or just get on track in general and do it, because this, it's the biggest distraction that you have in your current situation right now. This is the biggest distraction that many people have in their life right now, right? And what I'm talking about. Here, I will show you. So does this situation look familiar to you? I bet it, because we get distracted by this device so easily. And I think I don't actually also need to describe what kind of distraction, right? Just like notification and browser blackout, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean. This is why we also need to learn to turn it off if we want to get into the zone of focus, right? If we want to be productive. And when I said turn off, I really mean turn off. And this is my advice for you. Turn off your phone if you know you need to work on something. Or turn off your notification, or block every kind of notification and screen on stuff. Just turn it off. And the benefit is clear, because you don't expect to receive any kind of notification or message, because it's turned off. You don't receive anything. So you can concentrate on your task. And furthermore, you also save your battery. This is one small benefit that you might have if you have like an old phone like I used to do. And one more benefit that I want to share with you. So hands down, most of us are addicted to our phone. If you don't want to admit it, try to live without your phone for a week. This will show you how much addiction you actually develop over the time with your phone. By doing this exercise, so just turn off your phone when you want to be productive. This will help you to get control back. So we are at the end of this video, and yeah, what do you think about my advice? Do you have problem with retaining your concentration? And what are you going to do about it? What is the one advice that you can do right now to increase your productivity? Feel free to share it in the comment section below. And if you're liking my content, feel free to press the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Until then, as always, thank you for watching and see you next time on my next video.